Live Response gives a SecOps analyst instantaneous access to a potentially compromised machine, regardless of location, by using a remote shell. Analysts use this capability to quickly gather any forensic information that an investigation requires. I'll demonstrate how to enable and use Live Response in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. To enable Live Response, select Settings, and then Advanced Features. You must be a global admin to change these settings. You'll see two options. First, turn on Live Response to enable the core Live Response functionality. In Microsoft Docs, the page titled Investigate Entities on Machines Using Live Response offers a full list of basic and advanced commands available in Live Response. By default, analysts can only run signed scripts for obvious safety reasons. However, you can also turn on Live Response Unsigned Script Execution to give them the ability to run unsigned PowerShell scripts. This is not required to use the built-in Live Response functionality. To give a fuller demonstration, I'm going to enable both options and apply my settings. Now that Live Response is enabled, let's look at how to use it. That's next. This incident was created from a medium severity alert on Lori's machine. A suspicious file was run. I know that Microsoft Defender for Endpoint blocked the file, but I want to do a quick check to make sure everything is okay and the file isn't still in her profile. I'll select Machines and then open the Details page for Lori's computer. At the top, you see several actions. For this scenario, I'm going to initiate a Live Response session. And here we go. First, I'll review some of the information in the Live Response console. Selecting View Machine Details displays the machine details from Defender for Endpoint. You can also see who created the session, when it started, and how long it's been open. Remember, there are specific commands that we can use in Live Response. If you're not sure what they are, just type help. I'll go ahead and look at the running processes by running the processes command, and it displays a list of all the running processes. Quickly scrolling through them, I don't see anything that sticks out as suspicious. I also want to search for the malware file that Defender for Endpoint previously blocked, just to make sure it doesn't need to be removed from a download location. Doesn't look like this is still around, which is a good thing. Last, I want to run a quick PowerShell diagnostic script to do some additional checks. To do that, I'm going to select Upload File to Library and select my diagnostic script. After the script uploads, I can verify it's in the library by running the Library command. To run any script in the library, just type run, followed by the name of the script. Once it finishes, we'll copy the log path and run the file info command to get more information about it. Last, I want to download this file to my machine to review it. To do that, I'll run the get file command with the log file path in single quotes. And that's it. I now have the diagnostic logs from Lori's machine. By the way, if you ever want to go back to reference what you've done during the session, you can always use the command log. For example, I ran the processes command and I can review its full output. Last, when you're done, just select disconnect session to, well, disconnect the session. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint logs all your activities in the Action Center for audit purposes. Audit logging provides useful documentation for other analysts and helps to discourage nefarious use of Live Response. Live Response provides security analysts with real-time access to users' devices, even when they're not on the corporate network. Learn more about it on Microsoft Docs.